Hi, folks, and welcome back to The Shack. This is Joe N2DI, today with the MTech ZM2 antenna tuner. The ZM2 is a great little manual antenna tuner that covers 80 meters through 10. The maximum power rating on this ATU is 15 watts. It comes as a kit or pre-built, and I have a link in the description below if you want to find it. It's not an affiliate link. I'm not affiliated with MTech in any way. I just happen to own one of their tuners. In this video, I'll be showing you how I use it to match my random wire antenna. This video is in response to one of my subscribers who asked to see the tuner in action with the SW3B, which I also have right here. And before the pedantic loony starts screaming that it's not an antenna tuner because it doesn't actually tune your antenna, yes, we know if you've been a ham for longer than 5 minutes, you know what an antenna tuner is. And, you know, I'm going to refer to it as an antenna tuner, even though the name is misleading. You can refer to it as a transmatch or matchbox or an impedance match or whatever you call it, but for simplicity purposes in this video, I'll be referring to it as an antenna tuner. Okay, so with that, let's get started. I'm going to quickly run through the controls before we get started. I'll start from the top left and kind of move around the unit clockwise. Okay, so in the upper left, you'll have either a pair of BNC connectors or a pair of SO239 UHF connectors, depending on what you ordered. It comes with either or. One connection goes to your radio, and the other goes to your antenna. All right, to the right of that, you have a pair of BNC binding posts. This is where you can connect your balanced feed lines like ladder line, or you can connect your random wires directly to this if you want. Next, you have a toggle switch that toggles between the BNC connector and the binding post, so you could select where your antenna is connected. So if it's in the GND position, it's using the coax. If it's over in the link position, it's using the binding posts. So we're going to switch it over to GND for the time being. Okay, below that to the left, you have your two tuning knobs that tune your variable capacitors. To the left of that, you have a three position toggle switch that will toggle between 0, 250 picofarads and 500 picofarads of additional capacitance if you need to switch that in. To the left of that three position switch, you have another toggle switch and an LED. The toggle switch lets you switch in an SWR bridge. This will prevent you from doing any damage to your radio as you're messing with the controls and you have high SWR. So when it's up in this tune position, then you switched in the bridge. When it's down, it's out of the way, basically, and you're bypassing it. Okay, so I'm going to quickly hook this up to the SW3B, which I have down here, and my random wire. Okay, so the first thing to do is kind of reset the controls into a neutral position. So I'm going to turn both of the capacitors, the variable capacitors here, to 6. I'm going to switch the additional capacitance here to 0. I'm going to leave it in the tune position initially, and I'm going to make sure that this is switched, in this case, to ground because I'm using the coax. Okay, next I'm going to switch on the SW3B. I'll put it in frame here so you can see it. Now, when I switch it on, I have a key connected to it. When I switch it on, I'm going to be holding both of the panels together. That will switch the SW3B into straight key mode. Okay, normally if you don't do that, it'll come up with the key enabled. So I'm going to hold these together and I'm going to switch the radio on. Okay. Now I will turn up the volume and try to find an unused frequency right now. Okay. So you want the volume up a little bit so you can hear. And what we're going to do is now, I'm just going to push the radio out of the frame here and get back to the tuner. What you want to do is listen now for a peak in your audio with the capacitance switch and with the knob. So first, what I normally do is I sit here and I listen initially with this set to 0 picofarads, and I'll switch between 250 and 500 picofarads and listen for what makes the audio peak. See here, I got a little bit louder there. I got louder still when I switched to 500 picofarads. So I'm going to leave it in the 500 picofarad position. Okay. Next, I'm going to start turning the knobs and listening for a peak in volume. I don't really hear much of a difference here, so I'll just kind of leave it around 6. I'm going to turn the right one and listen. Okay, you can hear it got very quiet, so we're going the wrong way. Okay, so there's a peak around there. Okay, next you're going to want to switch the SWR bridge in line. Okay? Now, this is an unused frequency. I called QRL off camera prior to doing this. You want to make sure that it's not a used frequency. Now, I'm going to press and hold the key. And it's acting as a straight key now because I had held both of these in when I turned the radio on. So now, you see, when I put the key down, you'll see that the red LED lights up. So the goal here is to turn the capacitors till that light goes out. Okay, let's see if I can keep this up here. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so you should see that the LED went out completely now. So that's pretty much it. It's tuned. When you're out of whack and the SWR is high, that LED is going to illuminate. So you're going to want to keep turning either of these knobs. I just happened to get lucky this time that I just had to turn this one. But you're going to tune with both of the knobs until that light goes out, and then you should have your best SWR. Okay, so once you've tuned the capacitors so the LED goes out and you're ready to operate, all you need to do is switch this toggle switch down to the operate position, and you're ready to go. It's as simple as that. Okay, so I'm going to disconnect the SW3B and take the cable and plug it into my Rig Expert antenna analyzer, and we'll see if we did a good job tuning or not. Okay, and there we go. We've got 1.17 SWR, so not too bad, and it was pretty quick. So it's normally that quick to tune it. Okay, folks, so there you have it. It's that simple to use the ZM2 antenna tuner. Now, what makes this very easy to use is the built-in SWR bridge that you have here. Now, if you're using an antenna tuner, a manual tuner that doesn't have an SWR bridge, and you have a radio like the SW3B, which doesn't have an SWR indicator, you can get one of these. Now, this is a mini SWR indicator kit that I got from Pacific Antenna, and I can add a link in the description below. Again, I'm not an affiliate. I just happen to own this. Now, this comes as a kit. It has it's a SWR bridge, and I've soldered on the BNC connectors, the male and female, and it comes with the board with the resistors and the switch. And basically what this is this part of the antenna tuner. So you could switch your SWR bridge in line. You could put your attaches to your radio. You could put your coax free antenna here. And when you switch it into this position, the LED will light up if you have high SWR, just like it does on the ZM2. And then you could fiddle with your antenna tuner. And once that light goes out, you're good to go. So that would work if you do have a manual antenna tuner like this that doesn't have this SWR bridge. You could use this in place of that. Okay, and this kit, it's a tiny board with a few resistors. I think it's like $5 US. So check the link below for Pacific Antenna, and that's where you can find this. Okay? Otherwise, if you're using the ZM2, you don't need it. You could just use the built-in SWR bridge. But that's it, folks. Okay? Hope that helps. Thanks, everyone, and 73.